Hey, Abilities Dance Boston, congratulations on your $10,000 grant from the National Endowment for the Arts. As one of the leading employers of dancers with disabilities, your work is an important tool of representation, and I take inspiration from it as I continue to advocate for disability rights in Congress.
Well, exit, where we can just take a moment to locate all of the lighted exit signs and the theater in case of an emergency. Ushers are standing by to assist you. Also, that for the safety and comfort of others, we thank you for wearing your mask while in the theater, while not actively eating or drinking, to really protect our high-risk audience members as well as high-risk artists and admin folks, that we just want to keep our community safe. We also want to have a special thank you to our funders that have made this work possible, including our first corporate sponsors, Eastern Bank and Rockland Trust. So thank you for your support. And there are other organizational and specific funders for this ballet that are listed in the program as well. So I invite you to check those out. In addition, even though we have those funders, we really rely on the support of others to keep this work going so that we can continue to pay artists as equitably as possible. So if you are able to donate, you can go to abilitiesdanceboston.org/donate, where you can either find multiple ways to donate, or if you're in-house, you can come outside and we have a dip jar for you where you can dip your credit card and donate as well to continue to support those folks. Representative Vitola was here for our premiere last night and kind of opened us up by sharing that we, as a Brookline-based organization, collaborated with Gateway Arts, another Brookline-based organization that serves disabled visual artists, where we have hired some of those artists to paint canvases based on the themes of each of the scenes that you'll see tonight. Those canvases were inspired by Andrew, our director of music's music. And to be able to really kind of think about how we can continue to make ballet a multidisciplinary, accessible form of artwork. Our other community partners include Commonwealth Circus, where we are really inverting the theme of what ballet can be, as well as New England Film Orchestra, who is providing the live music, in addition to Tim Hall as a saxophonist, where you can see everyone's names listed in the program, and thanking them for the wonderful live music you will hear tonight. And Andrew has been our director of music, a wonderful co-conspirator in this process, where after our last year's ballet, Firebird, where we redesigned the ballet to fit different themes and ideas, we asked ourselves, what if instead we created our own story, wrote our identities from the very beginning, and how can that manifest? And that has evolved into what you see today. So a special thank you to Andrew for making this amazing work possible from the very beginning. Now, a little bit about the show. Fortunately, one of our dancers, Sam, had a family emergency, and so Dara stepped in on Thursday, learned the complete dance, and is assisting Dara. So when you hear the audio descriptions, that will actually be Dara instead of Sam. And so thank you, Dara, for stepping in and being able to continue the work and move that forward. Yay. We'll have two acts. Each act is about 45 minutes, with each scene being 10 to 15 minutes each. We'll have a 20-minute intermission where you can either, if you're in-house, go outside and go into the lobby and purchase inside their studios a book that features disabled artists, including myself, and t-shirts, or donate, or just hang out in concessions. And if you're virtual, you can also email us if you're interested in t-shirts or books. We want to be able to add a lot of support to and understanding of our work, both with our company and others in the wider disabled arts culture. In addition, we will not have Q&A after, but invite positive feedback over email. So you can email us at abilitiesdanceboston@gmail.com and share what resonated with you, what you thought of, and also how we can continue our access in improving that better. There are no flashing lights as another access point. So if you are feeling like you want to take some quick clips for socials, no problem. Have at it. Just tag us. And just make sure that your flash is off of your phones and that your screen brightness is low for our photosensitive dancers in the space. And this will be our last show here. So we're really excited to make this as memorable as possible and really challenge what ballet is, who is represented, the stories we tell. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Boston yet.
The New Boston. Welcome to the New Boston. Everything as we know it has been inverted. Time is not linear, but a collision of present and past. Issues that have been deemed too unbecoming to discuss for the greater good have been opened up for the world to see and actively dismantle. Journey starts in this inverted time of past meets present. Galpels Kylie, Sam, and Claire form a triangle where the white suffragette dresses with their red sashes to symbolize the blood lost over their white tears. Linda, excluded in her red dress and white sash, trying to belong, has left arm bent up and right arm bent in, that slides in and out along with left knee sliding in and out. Galpels bend toward us, pushing their savior when no one asks for it. They tiptoe back in embarrassment. To the notes, they hop an arabesque to show off their dainty womanhood. They lean deeper in the arabesque. Feet come together as they sway to the bassoon like flowers in the breeze. Linda joins them from afar. Legs sweep as they kick and push Linda from afar, and she bends over from that flow, white moves on the hips at me. They start to waltz towards the left as nothing happened as Linda recovers. Linda still tries to join as they continue to make beautiful steps across the stage and continue to shower us in charity. And again, no one asked for this. Hands rise as wrists cross. It seems as though there's a genuine moment to wash out inequities, but really it's just whitewashing the past. Under a moment of shared feminism, like the Pussy Hat Movement, Linda leans back, and the gal pals catch her. Renew. They spin together, Linda with even more vigor. Right leg swings up and around. They deeply end with heads raised. Rise to spin and back into a deep end. They slowly rise. Left hand rises over to cross right wrist. To the piano trills, they step back as if they'll find an answer in past feminist. You know, the racist ones. Hands connect and push out to the side as it leads them to spin as hands release. Linda has hands connected like a pendulum swinging, waiting for the times to change. Kylie, Sam, and Claire continue their work without including Linda's thoughts at all, but for the sake of all women, okay? They hop in place, never getting anywhere, while right hand arcs up and over and down into a deep bend. With this axe, Sam, then Kylie, then Claire rise and lower. Linda rises and stays, so we see her fully. To the vibraphone they rise. Linda stretches out from preconceived notions, all cross left hand over right wrist. They break out into their own phrases. Gal pals continually moving without Linda's insights, literally looking away from her as they continue moving. Linda, hoping in the good of women empowering women, tries to clean away the new mess that these gal pals create when they post a black square in a jeans with infographic without addressing things like BIPOC women can vote in 1820 but white women could and stop there. Linda starts to move around with space, still cleaning up the mess from those before her. Arms swing forward as she spins in a circle around the stage, moving around gal pals in their actually terrifying feminism that is only uplifting a certain type of woman and not all, which is still under the guise of white supremacy. Linda stays to the gal pals continue moving as one unit, impermeable to change. As hands connect, they release to side. As wrist and right ankle extend and rotate, they stretch on the floor. Left leg fan kicks around to face back, bouncing on hands with right leg extended. Linda is avoiding the scary white savior complex these gal pals have going on, navigating her way around the wildness. Gal pals back bend, reaching up to be grounded in the philosophy of trickle-down feminism, which doesn't work, by the way. Linda pauses in front of them to have right hand bent into left arm bent up and slides out as she finds beauty in the abstract shapes that leads to the innovative ideas becoming more intersectional in our feminism work. Linda reaches up right arm as Gal Pal's seated with their right and left leg. They're starting to get the point, but not quite yet. Linda's wrist and Gal Pal's ankles cross. All face back as they start pedaling their feet in a lunge. Real equity is brutal and exhausting. It takes time to build momentum, not just in goals, but in trust of all communities. Linda rises, trying to catch their attention of barriers that multiply marginalized folks as women and non-binary folks face, but the Gal Pals keep on their course, blocking out common sense. Gal Pals drop to the ground and roll over, feeling content as if they did something, swiping away their not-so-hidden biases they come up doing this work. All enter into a really deep bend with right arm curved up and left arm curved in. They slowly rise in unison. Right, then left arm crosses abdomen. They push 2 fingers out with the peace sign as the Gal Pal's hand gesture, which has nothing to do at all with the Girl Scout's hand gesture. It lowers and rises up for you. Let's invert the story, shall we? What if we acknowledge that I'm particularly white women, but other identities as well, have done under the guise of white supremacy? As dancers slowly spin like a dancer into the box, they rise on their toes while this creep to them fades. What if we as a community did real equity work internally and collectively to ensure that we understand the depths of this trauma? From white women colonizing Africa as missionaries to save them, to white women calling black and brown youth underserved from broken homes in need of their help through their nonprofits. Let's push back against this. Spinning left and swaying to the right, they enter a deep bend. Gal Pals lure to the sky as they humble themselves and learn more and letting conscious and unconscious biases float away. Linda now is faced with the task of skipping over their barriers. Sure, it is in the process of dismantling, but that doesn't mean immediately. Real equity shifts take time, and it doesn't matter any less as Linda waits for them to catch up to what she already knows. And it is exhausting to see because she has to keep skipping and keep skipping, lifting her legs as she grows weak, approaching burnout. To the stacks, Gal Pals rise, better than we left them. Sam, Kylie, and Claire. At each note. Now we're integrating into the community and working together. Linda's arms out at her sides, they lift her up, uplifting her story and carrying the burden so Linda doesn't have to. They lower her, each lunging out in a different sides, while Linda leans back, taking the moment in, walking, left arms circle as they bend, build connected energy into this movement. They roll down and rise, facing back, they rise on their toes, with curved arms up, right and left hand slowly lower, with feet tapping the ground, showing such strength and delicate movements. Pivot front arms lower to bend, and at their sides, reaching towards the right, then left, and an arabesque, all taking a moment to see them fully in their complex identities, now truly working as intersectional feminists instead of white feminists, that's just white supremacy and fancy letters. They reach left, then right, rounding this work to be an example for all. Backs of hands connect and push through center for this work to spread to different communities, swinging down and up, allowing themselves to feel the ecstatic whirlwind when we connect to others with dignity and not pity. They step backwards in different directions with hands and shoulders rotating. They form a diamond facing into each other. Across from each other, Linda and Claire grab hands, then Kylie and Sam stepping in and releasing, making a bigger diamond. They spin in a large circle around the stage and pause. They step into each other again, Claire and Linda's, then Kylie and Sam's ankles connecting. Their hands overlap in a moment of community intimacy. They spin out to each corner. Hands reach up, grounded in their truth, and lower to kneel with hands clasped. They rise with hands spinning up, committed to continue their unlearning, committed to show their communities this new way of being that equitably includes everyone. Claire spins to the floor in front of Linda. Linda rises on Claire's back with Linda's legs bent up behind and holding onto her shoulders. Kylie and Sam support Linda's legs, a moment of truly uplifting people and stories that haven't been told. And we're just getting started. Like disjointed memories, we move to a place that seems present but reeks of outdated mindsets. Left to right, Lauren, Shai, Carmen, and Kate stand. Right arm slides across chest, reaching for inclusion, and rises towards the ground. The lower as left arm rises towards the ground. Left knee and elbow connect and extend out. Legs swivels to the saxophone notes to release. They bend down towards the sky, hoping to go high as others go low in this racial equity superhero stereotype. Hand to head as they look up to the ground, seemingly elevating racial consciousness, but is only driving further into the ground. They slide into a plank to the right, then left, pushing hands against ways to further include multiply marginalized BIPOC, then rise. They whip torsos round and pause to lean their torso and left leg up to make a T with their body and repeat to the right. They slide into a deep bend with arms looking up but to the ground, still committed to their version of equity work. They brush their foot and spin to the right, committed to their equity trainings but not equity practice, showing up how accepting they are to all people externally while doing nothing internally. Bent left leg rises and swings to the side while bending with arms curved in. They spin and flow through the body, inviting us into this time of racial reckoning. They lower to the sky and roll in the clouds of their expectation of a racially just society, while leaving some of us behind. Legs bend into each other as they extend out into this dream state. They thought this dream state would be a congratulatory space to pat on the back for their job well done. But this isn't that. They sit on their knees and wave arms like fleeting interest. Let's cut to the chase. Your racial equity work that is inaccessible only considers cisgender folks, only accepts respectability politics, and denies low-income or houseless perspectives, and more, is white supremacy under the guise of stop dividing interest and unite under one cause. Please. They stand on their knees and roll back down to the sky as hands flourish. Some of our greatest ableism instances individually and as a company have been from BIPOC and especially Black leaders who perpetuate the idea that our work is separate from racial equity, that our people are not a part of their community served, and it hurts. It really hurts. Right, then left hand slides up chest and into the air. Some of us feel at the intersections of race and disability, queer, trans and disability, and more like we are not a part of Black Boston or other diverse communities. Your equity meetings happen without captions and translators. You refuse to change flash photography or have flashing lights at events. They take place in ADA non-compliant buildings. My favorite is, can you hear me without a mic? I don't need it. You don't, but we might. Sitting on knees as hands continue to sway up. How can you call yourself abolitionist while actively excluding so many, no longer in the New Boston? They rise to spin. What if we allow this time for radical reimagining? What if instead of thinking about how much BIPOC and especially Black folks are oppressed in one way, we consider that some of us are oppressed even more in the community? What if we stopped and truly listened and learned from all so we can liberate all? Standing and quivering as they unlearn their biases in activism work, reaching down and up twice, starting to take in what that means for their movement work. They start to run around each other, starting to avoid accountability and the hard truth that their work has actually served the very cause they want to fight against. And to be clear, this is not a judgment. This is a reckoning to learn and push our shared goal of liberation, but for everyone. They form a square and spin at different times. Right foot taps up leg as arms rise. They jump into a lunge and reach left, then circle arm up while facing right and looking up. Assessing what their ground principles have been to evaluate what stays and what goes. Katie and Carmen reach left, then jump with legs bent to the left as Shy and Lauren stay still, figuring out how to integrate themselves into this movement. Katie and Carmen kick while leaping again with legs bent to the right. Their bent right knee and elbow almost connect and pull it out. They lunge while caressing face, centering themselves in this moment when they shouldn't be. They deeply bend to the sky, realizing they have learning to do. Face right as arms rotate and grasp head to continue absorbing knowledge from theory and folks' lived experiences. They slide into split as Shy and Lauren bend with wrists together and hands out, integrating themselves into their movements so they are not forgotten. Katie and Carmen rise. They slink side to side, trying to show their strength but realizing their strength in stillness and listening. Lauren and Shy walk backward, then up to Kate and Carmen. Their right arm interlocks with Kate and Carmen's inner arms. Release and then whip torsos around, elated in this prospect of inclusion. They walk in between Kate and Carmen to lunge, rolling through their torsos. Skipping to be in front of them, they pull their leg as they begin this work of bringing racial equity advocates further in their equity journeys. Ankles tap as they swing leg around. Shy and Lauren swivel leg to extend behind facing left. Hands connect as they extend out, back to to back Kate and Carmen bend down as they carry the weight of Shai and Lauren. Carrying the burden of access education so they don't have to explain how they exist in every room they enter. Their torso rolls as they come down. Lauren and Shai sweep to the side as Carmen and Kate roll towards the left. Carmen lies on top of Kate as she rolls over her. Starting this long, uncomfortable, reciprocal journey of being more intersectional in their activism, regardless of how either identifies, it is still rooted in white supremacy when they are not thinking about liberation of all BIPOC and actively intend to leave some behind. Shai and Lauren, on the borders, silently swept their work forward, even if they are not recognized for their part in pushing their movement forward towards all. Carmen rises to arabesque, using Kate's hand in a moment of community. They skip in different directions and face in different ways in a line. Shai, Kate, Lauren, and Carmen form a line. They lean on each other in a moment of realizing community is the only way we'll move forward. Kate and Lauren rotate torsos in and out of the sequence. Shai and Carmen make large circles with their arms, like the wheels of a wheelchair, and Kate and Lauren's like the axle that keeps the equity movement stable and connected and forever moving. What if in the New Boston we learn from and embrace neurodivergence as a diverse mind capable of anything instead of a deficit? Leslie and Jamie face us with right bent arm and left bent leg rising and down, arms straightened, suspend them with arms diagonally, arms wrap in a moment of self-soothing and this overstimulation, legs kick back and forth in a comforting repetition. They open up and skip back with arms circling. They repeat this phrase to the right as stemming gives them strength. Right arm bends up and left arm swipes across it in this beautifully abstract shape. Spinning and hopping, side to side, creates this fuzzy frame feeling as the clock melts, making time abstract too. Arms rise. Right arm and left leg bend up, facing left, then right. Arms brush off distractions as I hyper-focus on this dance. Like a pendulum rocking on a clock, facing left to right, bigger and bigger. Right arm circles overhead and leads to spin them in a form of self-regulation. Feet tiptoe around the floor to minimize sensation. Leg kicks around with arms curved up to face left. Right, then left hand comes to head in the strain of processing new movements and social interactions. Hands release to lower torso, reaching in the same direction and spinning underneath arm as bent right arm lowers with left arm extended. They hop into a deep bend, rooted in the sky as arms open wide. They lower to sky, embracing the breeze of fleeting memories. Curved arms rise and open. Reaching down to pivot up with left bent leg facing in towards each other. Looking down with bent arms at their face as if searching for the right words in the middle of a brain fog. Unwrapping and spinning with arms at their sides like a fidget toy. They pause as arms bend in. They flick back assumptions of what neurodivergence looks like as they repeat movements in a moment of self-soothing. Now is a good time to remind you that neurodivergence is more than autistic white boys. They circle with bent arms to show the abstraction of neurodivergence. They lower to their knees, reaching out hands to offer that neurodivergence is even more than autism. Lowering to sit with left arm extended out, rooted in the sky and spectrum of this identity, pushing pelvis up with arm to assert femininity in this identity, sitting arms grab head as they deal with the frustrations of a mind in a world not made for us, bending into themselves and reaching up. One arm extending out for relief from the brain fog of this strange neurotypical way of thinking. Finding balance in the wind of swirling thoughts, they rise with hands on the ground. Right leg kicks side to side and across as they stand and pivot back. They both find comfort in different stimming ways. FYI, stimming is not just making weird movements, but using the body to calm ourselves in a very triggering world. In the New Boston, this is normalized in every space and every position, including executive leadership. Arms continue to brush off how in the past we've mastered memory loss, twitching, and other ways we've tried to fit in. Left arm guides right hand around to face right. Struggling to balance between intrusive thoughts, they slide into a lunge. Back right leg bends up as torso lowers to fit in the beam of abstract shapes like abstract thoughts in our mind. Arms bend in at their chest facing us as they lower into an arabesque, showing us how to understand our diverse minds and bodies. Spinning to face left with right and left hand, pushing against societal norms meant to exclude us. Hands slide up to head as we work through the intensity of brain fog while still performing and existing in a neurotypical way. They walk backwards against this need to mask how they exist from the old Boston. Right hand rises as left hand lowers it to left hip as hands slip over into the right arm, circling and reaching out and down. Arms form a V, then hands make fist over their chest. Torso rolls in this moment of self-actualization. Left hand caresses cheek and down as they find comfort within their community. They hop into an arabesque in a moment of joy. Hand circles around as they skip right to left like the nonlinear journey of time we neurodivergence experience. But we always support one another, like Jamie's and Leslie's, arms interlocking. They connect in various ways, like we support one another with diagnosis information, medicine reaction, executive functioning hacks, and the reminder of our humanity in old Boston that refused to see us as capable employees and leaders in the workplace and overall community. Leslie's hand slides down Jamie's arms in a moment of decreasing overstimulation that causes many of us to pause at life, release facing each other's hands and ankles cross. Jamie supports Leslie as she leans back with right leg rising in a moment of reciprocal care from neurodivergent folks. Stepping away and facing each other, hands come to opposite shoulder. As they step towards the right corner, as hands make patterns, touching different parts of the body, and hop to repeat towards left corner. ankles connect as we push away from each other again. Hand touches forehead in a moment of relief, looking up towards grass and down to the sky with bent knee connecting to elbow. Pivot to front, left wrist and rising ankle turn in a moment of calming the body and owning your own grip turn. Left arm extends to side as they lunge forward. Hands bent in at their sides as torso rolls, wondering how to get folks to embrace the new Boston now that Warner and Emergence are proud and safe together. They jump into an X, back in, and again, each time nurturing their needs and their time for themselves to breathe. Hand shoots out in a diagonal as they hop left and right, facing front, their hands clasp as left leg rises and pivots to face right. Lower torso rolls as hands release. They rise with bent arms and bent knee rising. Torso lowers as arms circle them around to the left. Arms release and make an X across the chest as they slowly pivot. They lower to the sky as their neurodivergent identities are being questioned in this time of community seeking. Grounding higher into the sky, they explain how neurodivergent includes many identities, including PTSD, epilepsy and seizure-causing disorders, traumatic brain injuries, ADHD, and more. Which is what literally all of us dancers, myself and Andrew, identify as. And these identities manifest in different ways when you take into account racial cultural backgrounds, regional dialects, and more that exists on a spectrum far beyond autism, which is a more resourced and understood. That is until you get out of the K-12 system and become an adult. That's for next year's ballet. They rise. They continue openly stemming in an act of defiance. They set the tone for what it would mean with neurodivergence as a norm and things like direct language, easy access to resources, and other elements that make the city truly welcoming to all minds. Back to back, in the back, Leslie bends backward as Jamie supports her bending over. They release. Wrist cross and hands connect in a moment of access intimacy. Hands cross chest and release as they do a series of spins towards the front, each time picking up their inner leg to the alternate knee as they brace us with their presence. Bright bent arm rises as head tilts right. Left bent arm rises to hip as they embrace the metaphysical relationship between mind and body. Hand touches forehead as they look up to grass and ground at that in crib time. The past and present will always converge for many neurodivergent folks, but we continue on this wonderfully complex and new Boston where our voices will matter. They stretch into a deep bend as hands wrap themselves around in a hug, an act of self-care as wrists cross and hands rotate around each other and rise. Hands release as arms make large circles around, reminding us that time isn't linear and we must learn from and embrace the past and present if we can ever sustain change in Boston in the future, for neurodivergence and all.
probably Swedish, though, honestly.
It's
more prevalent in Sweden.
Definitely more prevalent in Sweden, but it was, it's my, it's so cool. I love a little amplified display.
I think it'd be a fun opportunity to double one.
Definitely.
And incorporate saxophone as well, because the saxophone doesn't utilize.
It doesn't.
Even like, I was just...
We're good, how are you?
Yeah, you're good.
I didn't, I'm just noticing now that the last scene, you don't have the little, like, things on top, and now you do.
Yeah, but now you can have that.
Oh.
I like it.
Neat.
I like it. It makes sense.
You can talk to it.
Well, and now we're into burnout, right?
Exactly.
So, like, you're covering all that you are to be something more, or different.
It's perfect, because we're all pretty burnt out, so.
Yeah.
Exactly. Every time we talk about, like, this dance, I always think in my head, like, when in doubt, just act tired.
Yeah.
Like, it's the perfect
sometimes
scapegoat.
Sometimes not even
there. Exactly. Like, I can pull out of something and make it a burnout vibe.
Yeah. This is quite the piece. Let's
yeah.
Sure this one. Chugs.
Musically, too.
Mm-hmm. Just a lot of, like,
yeah.
So many layers.
It was so repeated,
yeah.
And it's really
and
hard.
Layers.
Sometimes it's hard to remember where you are. Like,
you're, like, playing the same thing over and over, and you're like, is this the fourth or fifth time I've played this?
Right.
Like, if you look at this page, like, each measure pretty much looks the same.
Wow, yeah,
really. But it
just goes up and up
like
and up. No, it doesn't sound like that, for
no,
sure.
Because, like you said, we're all building on top of each other.
Not as monolithic, yeah.
He's
great composer.
Yeah.
It's
impressive, and he did it in 2 weeks.
Well, it's hard to fill up that amount of time, too.
That's what
I didn't know that.
Well, because I didn't get the music. Like, I got the music in little bits. Like, first I
that's
had
right.
Something.
We got draft one, draft two, draft
and I was like, huh.
Oh, yeah, I didn't see draft. I just remember when it all came in at one big chunk, at least my part.
Yeah, I had everything except movement two for a while. And I was like, oh, I probably don't play much for movement two. I'm just playing in sleep for it.
Hmm. I'm glad that went better today.
It did. And it was nice to, like, I feel like it ended really beautifully.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, the end of two.
Yeah.
With the timing and the lighting and the music.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back to our second act of Inversion. A couple notes to share. In ours, between scene 5 and 6, it will seem like it's a big group ending because the curtains will go down, but the show is not over yet, so don't leave. We will just be transitioning for the final scene, and we need to close the curtains to do so. Another personal note, worked hard to put some jokes in there, so please laugh harder. Ha ha. Or not, no pressure. All right. Let's get it started.
This journey has been long and exhausting. Leslie, Andrea, and Jamie stand, forming a triangle representing strength and unity. Bent right arm and left leg rise. They pivot to face back on their knees. In the midst of chaos, the movement is slow. Legs swiping behind as arms wrap, looking over their shoulder at us, looking left. Wondering if the audience sees beyond the shine into their daily fatigue. Right, then left leg lifting while on knees as they look again, inviting us into the story. Facing front with arms extended on one knee. Left hand lowers as right leg extends into a side plank. The intensive movements match the intensive energy they've been putting out in order to do this work. They lower into seated with knees bent out at their sides, bent arms rise, left arm, then right arm, arcs overhead. Legs slide in as arm bends over each other in this abstract shape of delirium. Bent arms at their sides to question how they got here. They reach left, then right. Hands bend into themselves as if trying to do self-care, but fleeting as it extends out. They extend arms up, hoping to be balanced and rooted. Right arm arcs over as it carries left arm to the left. They repeat to the right as if they're becoming too weak to continue. They push into a plank and roll up to stand. Arms circle behind as if time is vanishing and they can't grasp it. Spinning left. Then right. They push against these ideas of what it means to be an advocate while also finding within themselves how to continue this work without the burning out that makes us leave the field. Right foot swings back and forward flexes the heel rest on the floor and arms bend in. They spin out and lunge with elbows bent up. They spin again and right leg extends to bend to the ground. Right hand pushes to the right, left hand pushes to the left, more wearily asking for assistance on their path to total burnout. Right hand circles around left as it continues to spin them around to stand. Hand slowly lowers to their side. They swing their torsos in a moment to center and block out external pressures. Lifting heels, they deeply bend with right arm arced up as they bend back, still showing grace in this tiring moment as they rise. They walk in a circle around the stage, rubbing their sternum as if all is self-soothing, calming the body during this heightened state of hyper-awareness. Feet slide behind them. Their hands roll up to their face. In a moment of running through racing thoughts of the mind, they lower their upper body, grabbing headache in to rise up. Feeling the weight of this work, right bent leg rises, they spin with torso lowered, swinging arms behind them in a release and back. Elbows and right leg bend in to touch each other. They reach out and hoping for the rest and tranquility. Bent arms and a bright mountain-like rise as if offering the idea of peace during an intensive period, an intensive 2 years or more. They lean to the side and rotate to face right into an arabesque. Right, then left arm, bend into side as they pivot front. Right hand slides down left arm as we wipe away the even stronger burnout feelings for those who exist in the communities the organization is supposed to support. Hand pushes out as they spin. It opens up at the thought of new practices and closes back in at the extra work to develop new practices. Arms open up anyway for the long-term investment in self. Arms extend to side as they deeply bend, hands connected in the sky. They slowly rise, committed to taking care of self as a form of community care. Arms rise as they balance on toes. They slowly walk into arabesque to bring more enjoyment and fluidity to the movement. Spin and skip back with more joy. They think of different ways that they've been burned by the arts and culture sector, moments of rest they found with each other. Leslie creating abstraction within her mind that she has felt in the studio when rehearsal practices didn't consider her needs. Jamie's exhaustion from multiple entities and the need for support when she lays on the back of Andrea. Andrea who felt the weight of this work, hearing Jamie while struggling to move forward. They release as Andrea and Leslie both caress each other's faces in a moment of excess intimacy as Jamie makes abstract shapes and an arc across the stage. They come into each other and extend out. Jamie and Andrea reach towards each other. Leslie breaks that, inviting more community in as they face back. Arms wrapped around each other, they lower to the ground. Circle right leg around to kneel. Resting on knees, they look back to us. Seeing if we understand the toil of burnout of work in ourselves. Arms cascade on each other's shoulders. They sweep back around the floor. Bent arms rise. They pivot to the front with arms rooted in the sky of possibilities. Arms open up. Facing back and center, Andrea and Jamie on either side, rotating through their torsos in a lunge to create a wave of community care amidst the burnout, to remind each other of their humanity, that it is okay to take a break, especially when the identity is your work. They roll across each other. Leslie's arm reaches on Jamie's chest as Andrea kneels in front of her, bent with arms extended. At their side, they rise to stand side by side, knocking each other's shoulders in a moment of full release, knowing they're supported. They release, forming a triangle with Leslie as the top point, sharing the knowledge of continuing to thrive in this challenging landscape. Hands open in the center as they bend deeply. And back. They sway in the comfort that they will rest and heal with community. Nine dancers stand stoically across the stage, their various colors representing the various identities they hold, walking towards us with arms outstretched, bending to gather the roots of community support and rising higher than before. Leaning to left and bending deeply, right arm circles overhead, adding connectedness to each other, being in unison. We rise with arms reaching out. Left leg rises and circles around like a compass needle looking for siblinghood, bending deeply again to find those roots as arms circle overhead again to find the cycles of various communities one finds in a lifetime. Bent left leg rises as they rotate like a dancer in a jewelry box. Individual voices and movements, starting with shy, reaching down and up, looking for community in this new Boston landscape, opening up the space for others to learn voices. Andrea reaches down for a deeper sense of community, surrounded but still isolated, spinning and opening up arms for Linda to join. Linda receives that offering as she faces back with arms curved, waving with the highs and lows of the community outside of Boston and New City. Hands connect, pushing out and overhead as torso drops from the exhaustion of finding a new city. Kylie understands that sentiment for rises and hope, leg kicking forward and back at the 12 community work can take, resisting that burnout and gracefully lunging to pause and rest as an act of community care. Claire lunges to continue the community work and pushes one hand out as the other slides down her arm as a violin post slides on the string. They release and open up as she spins in the new freedom, abolishing white feminism gives to all and feeding her versions of white women. Wrapping herself in care, Kara also wraps hands around her torso as hands connect and swap with herself and others in the access intimacy community provides and finds rest. Kate meets her at the resting point and continues swiping foot across the floor to clean out discrimination in all forms of the community, realizing the intersection all systems of oppression rely on and opening herself up for Lauren and Carmen to embrace, swiping hand across just as we work together to swipe out the ableism of racial equity work. Realizing without it's just another fluid connection to white supremacy, they call on all of the community for this moment of reckoning. Everyone's right hand rises and flows down the center of their body, arms windmill as they spin. Right bent leg rises and opens up as they navigate this new siblinghood. Facing back, right leg rises as hands find their roots and ground and sit. Arms rise to the right and left like the flowing nature of mutual aid that gives and receives. Right leg extends back as torso rests on floor and rises with leg rising like the black aerial we're excited to see soon. It swipes around as right hand rests on knee, waiting for the representation we demand to see on screen, on stage, and in all kinds of leadership. Pivot on one knee to the screen, on the radical movement building as they spin. They step backwards as wrists turn, shaping the collective identity. Right and left leg rises to the sky as arms extend, adding even more force to the sea. tracking like a compass, creating the structure for all to thrive. They spin to the right and leap or lower to the floor. They rise on their knees with arms extended, right arm bends back, left arm extended, like a bow shooting an arrow through respectability politics and all the thinly veiled antiquated ways of working that are they rise to stand. Arms rise, crossed at wrist. It lowers to the left as hands hold onto his wings, then squashes hands connect and lend you on celebration. The group splits in two as they skip to the outer edges, pushing the leg further, and then back to lean in onto the knee. Facing back, arms rise as they look up towards the grass of the inverted. Hands float down like flower petals going down towards the sky, shifting like autumn to make way for something beautiful. They take time to walk around this space, meeting each other's eyes as they make these instant and fleeting moments of connection in different communities. They form a half circle, inviting us to see their individual voices again and say their truth. Andrea starts from the far right, walking to the center and spinning while the rest stoically sink hand, sending healing and connection to the center, opening arms up and lunging right hand, holds up elbows, it slides to wrap and reaches up and brings energy into their stomach, feeling nourished by the connections here. They walk back to their place. As Carmen enters, reaching out to express herself in her pockets of community, reaching in different directions to get enrichment from different communities to make herself whole. Arms swing down as foot taps and she repeats, calling on her core group to help navigate this new Boston. She reaches up to the grass to find the earth expanding towards equity. Carmen leaves as Linda enters. Linda finds community virtually like many of us do, and escaping the inaccessibility of so many events and venues, there is a platform that is more equitable where we can connect, laugh, cry, and feel the universal desire to belong in any space we enter. Linda leaves as Dara enters, listening to others in their journeys. She slowly rotates with bent left leg and elbow connected and lifted. It extends out as arms open wide to wrap around herself as she feels community and sharing further as she spins. Elbows push through the space to protect from any forms of inequity. She invites us to listen to others' journeys for a more equitable community as she moves. Kate enters kneeling, then sitting on ground. Left arm rises as she's rooted in the sky, traveling from west coast to this new Boston. Arm and knee rotates to right as wrist cross and rise. She knows rebuilding community like equity work takes time. It must happen brick by brick so that it cannot be. Lauren steps to center with arms continuing to build her fabric like she built her new crafting business in JP. She leans and kicks, hands open like a book with her hand in foot corners and her foot cloth. Arms rise as light kicks and brushing off notions of neighbors having no intentions. She knows her community can be there for her like she is for them. Lauren. Arms make a large circle overhead, feeling supported in her dance collective. Arms cross as she arabesques and slowly spins like a dancer in a jewelry box, understanding the power dance has to change mindsets and communities, in a deep bend, realizing that it won't always be perfect, but the community will always hold her accountable, non-intentional harm, and actively working to ensure those arms don't repeat. She leaves as Shai enters. Chai reaches up, left hand overlaps right, as fingers form this web as they spin, like the web of meeting different needs. Now access intimacy is interdependent to ensure there is space for all to thrive. Hands release as force of eyes with arms rising like diving into a new Boston that dismantles capitalism and ensures everyone has their needs met to stay alive and moves toward a community that focuses on radical joy in the aftermath. They leave as Kylie enters. She lunges to the right with left hand on right arm, rising her foot and makes circles on the ground as she draws out dreams of the future with multiple layers of community able to show up for one another. She spins with exhilaration when finds in this new Boston. Right arm, then ten, and left arm extended. She walks, then runs along the half circle, taking the beauty of diversity in our city that we don't take time to honor enough. She returns, then deeply lunges and extends arms out, inviting everyone to come together. They form a line like dominoes of joy, community, and intersectional equity work. They make various poses, leaning on each other, Claire balancing on hands, wrapping legs around Kate and Kylie supporting her upper body, Shy and Lauren making a heart to remind all that at the heart of this equity work is love, Dara supporting Harmon's hips as she thrusts in the support offered, all pausing in this moment of a representation of the new Boston. curtains open, all five paintings are ground white silks hanging in the center. Elise, I, and Vivid Purchase. Head circles around to stand. I spin to notes and extend arms out. Have we found what the through line is between all of these pieces? It's intersectionality. All of these experiences happen to a Black, openly disabled woman, often at the same time hoping to find community in various movements. I use openly disabled because I've had more Black women and non-binary folks in arts and culture and or in Boston reach out with our specific overlapping concerns and needs as I realize this isn't quite specific to me. While I use the journey of myself and others to hear, to feel the arc and the story so that it continues to be more universal, this is where it started. I slowly walk in a deep lunge and up to stand and repeat. It has been a long journey. I start at the first painting as I drop first crutch and hands float next to me. Gal pals. This story has been a longer, more sinister tale, starting with suffragettes where white men and more autonomy than missionary work, right to vote, and all the while in leadership over nonprofits, as transporters of white supremacy and women's and neighborhoods, not theirs, so much of really tell them the equal rights because patriarchy can be separated from white supremacy. I spin to the next painting and drop other crutch, letting both hands run. Similarly, there's been some real nasty ableism in racial equity work. I and others have openly felt it. Others secretly have felt it for job security, desire to feel connected in community, and other very, very valid reasons. Someone really should tell the racial equity folks inaccessibility is killing us, and ignoring those, especially identifying as BIPOC, to only think of racial equity work and non-disabled terms first and only, is eugenic stuff, type stuff, which also can't be separated from white supremacy. Spinning to the next painting, I love how this painting makes the abstract shapes from our neurodivergent history. Because of reasons I identified in the last painting, I did not publicly identify as neurodivergent because of the specific identities with in until this year, until I felt I had the job security to openly share, which is still a fear, but silence kills, and it was literally killing me. And then others came out or finally got the diagnosis they've been fierce for, and showing the beautiful abstract shapes we can create with our movement or music or whatever else we create or contribute, we're able to normalize a beautifully wide spectrum of brains that see and process the world differently. I spin to the next painting, bending a bit and growing tired. Everyone's favorite topic, burnout. We feel it a lot in arts, culture, nonprofit, or service work. We feel it especially hard when we identify with the communities we're serving. We work harder because we know it is serving the world or loved ones you never forgot. I continue to explore heavier hand and leg movements here. And a great place to add my special flavor of burnout, because of my experiences, I want folks to get paid as equitably as possible, being only or close to the role they were hired for, and not because I have some control issue. I'm quick to cut folks off and say, please check in with Elizabeth or get Andrew's approval, etc., so those we do have feel the agency and leadership they're able to have. Until I get there, I do more than I should so I can get funds to delegate, and I even more too. Community. Next painting. Listening to others explain their connection or disconnection to different forms of community made for a very large dance for led piece. My favorite is leaving the virtual room or in-person room and allowing folks to either create and try out new ideas or just be present with one another. It not only creates a strong work community, but one that is beyond just product and cares about the well-being and joy of everyone in the room. I walk back to my crutches, waltz towards the center. I pirouette, feeling the energy of all of those pieces radiating to and from me as we all have mindsets shifted and personal or professional protocols advocated for because of this work. Right arm points left and around to graze silk and back. I lower to the ground and drop both crutches, right hand points up to the sound of the music. Left wrist crossing over right wrist as it comes to touch right shoulder, then both hips and down into a semi plank, rolling over to one side as I contract out and in. Rolling back up to knee with left hand touching ground and right hand rising with right leg extending out. Repeat to the left side. Wrists come together for hands to curve up and release as backs of hands touch and drive down while arms extend out. Bent arms come in as right palm and left palm reach up. Left hand lowers to ground as pelvis pushes up in a moment of seeing more of me, seeing more of all of us. It lowers to rest back on knees, hands clasped as they lower on a diagonal. Release to right hand shooting up and lowering on diagonal to bring them to sit on my knees. I grab crutches and rise to stand. I spin and spin until I'm on the silk's right side. I release my left crutch in the diagonal and then stand on the silk's left side. I release my right crutch in a diagonal to release right hand. I let hands explore the back. I grab the silks and make beautiful ripples in the air, like our art going out to everyone. My limbs fall in and out of view as I move through these ripples, making sense of this new Boston in light of a very real old one. My brain moves in and out of time because of PTSD and other neurological disorders, I'll say for next year's ballet, but like dissociation for a cause, it moves in and out of what my hopes could be for my city. I grab the silks to stop standing behind them as my arms rise at side and lead and grab to make a large knot. Like Dora the Explorer standing in front to put straps on like a backpack, I turn to face back and I then invert myself where my legs are extended out on one side. Then bend in to extend again. My right leg rising up one silk as my left leg extending out in front like a gazelle-like shape. I twist my body to make a beautiful arabesque shape, holding onto one silk, looking down. Release to be upright with one leg bent on the silk and the other bent underneath. I spin, hanging on with both arms, as I then lean back and enjoy this moment. I bring in my feet to breathe, and I stand. It's the hardest thing I've ever done, but I stand. And I don't have to breathe so hard. can just exist. One foot comes through as the other side extends out like the goddess archer. My right hand, dainty and forceful, makes movements that bring back home, whether through wild aerial work or just with my hand. I command attention with all versions of things. I sit up and look. With hands still sliced through the silks, I take steps around the circle and leads me to hold lights up as I run. I feel the exhilaration of running and soaring I can't feel in the old Boston. Holding the bottom, I gather at the silk as I walk backwards. Like trying to unfurl time, I wonder how I or any of us at this point could go back to the old Boston, to inaccessible art, to charity that will never mean equity, and so much more. Let's stay here a little longer. I walk to the center, holding silk, and walk. I wrap my leg around the fabric and tie my foot in a hold. I stand. I circle my entire body around the hold, using my arms to pull my full body around the silk two times. Take a moment to rest and let my free arms and leg dangle in the air, enjoying the magic of this moment, uplifting the disabled aerial royalty friends that introduced me to this work, like Toby McNutt, Kinetic Light, and the countless others I don't know but have the pleasure of being connected into me. I unentangle my body from the fabric and unhook my body. I take a moment to breathe, wrapping my arms around the fabric as I allow my torso to bend over as I struggle to breathe. I know the new Boston isn't real, but why can't it be? Why can't the things that exist in my dreams, my company's dreams, our community's dreams, exist in our city? I fall to my knees and rise, knowing this bridge between new and old has lasted for generations past and for generations to come, as long as we continue forward. While we're here, let's make dope art and do real equity for ourselves and our communities, and remember to still enjoy the vibrancy and beauty of life while we do it, day by day.